In this short video, I'm going to highlight one of the most frequent problems which can happen to your dogs at this time of year, sprains and soft tissue injuries. Make sure to watch this short video to learn how to avoid these common injuries and how to naturally treat them if they happen. Sound good? Make sure you hit that like button if you're all for helping your pets live a long and vibrant and healthy life. I'm Dr. Katie Woodley, a holistic veterinarian and founder of The Natural Pet Doctor. We're on a mission to make sure incredible pet parents like you have all the tools you need to help your pets thrive naturally. You can find more of our free pet health content at thenaturalpetdoctor.com. First, let's start with how do these happen? Strains and sprains can happen commonly when your dog overworks itself. Think about your own self getting out of winter without much activity, and you try to run a marathon for the first time without working up to it. These strains and sprains come from our dogs not being ready and can affect the muscles or the ligaments. So for example, a torn cruciate knee ligament or like an ACL tear in people. So what are some of the signs of a sprain or strain in your dog? The most common sign is limping. Many dogs will not vocalize when they're in pain or when they've hurt themselves. But if you notice them not bearing weight on that paw or that leg, it's painful. Other common signs include swollen paws or joints, getting grumpy if a certain area is touched, lameness after activity, toe touching on their hind leg. And if you notice any of these signs, make sure to contact your veterinarian. Your vet may need to do an x-ray to make sure nothing is broken or that nothing else is going on. Also, a physical exam by your veterinarian can help identify what's happening so you can fix it more quickly rather than guessing what happened. So if your dog has sprained their leg, what are some of the natural remedies you can use safely to help reduce inflammation and support healing? Number one is to make sure you're resting your dog. You can use a crate if you have one and if they're used to being in a crate. And if you don't, make sure to reduce their activity. This means no hikes until your dog is using that leg more readily. And if you have a crazy pup outside, make sure to put them on a leash to go to the bathroom so that they don't chase after a squirrel or rabbit and make the injury worse. I've seen it over and over where a dog is healing his injury, goes outside to go to the bathroom, sees a squirrel, takes off, and comes back into the house limping and even more sore than the first injury. Here's the best part though. There are a few natural treatment options that you can use to help your pet heal even faster. Acupuncture is powerful at helping to reduce inflammation naturally and help the body produce its own natural pain-relieving chemicals like endorphins and opioids. My own German Shepherd tore both of his cruciate ligaments, and we were able to avoid surgery due to acupuncture and some of the other natural remedies I'm going to mention. Physiotherapy is another great option to help regain mobility and prevent your pet from losing muscle strength. Make sure to ask your veterinarian if they can refer you to a practitioner that provides these services if your vet doesn't offer these at their clinic. And finally, there are some key supplements that you can use to support joint health, reduce inflammation, and provide natural pain control without the side effects that can come from conventional pain medications like non-steroidals and opioids. Getting your dogs on a good joint supplement that has glucosamine, chondroitin, MSM, and even greenlit muscle will help reduce chronic inflammation that can lead to more problems like osteoarthritis down the road. These nutraceuticals are known to support the joint cartilage and prevent further damage while decreasing inflammatory mediators to help relieve pain naturally. Also, using treats and supplements that have collagen present can be very powerful. Foods like bone broth can be added to your dog's normal diet, or even collagen sticks from companies like Natural Farm can be helpful. Not only do using healthy treats provide enrichment while your pup is out of action for a little bit, but it'll provide the necessary building blocks to heal the inflammation and get your dog back on the trail. Other natural supplements that can help your pet's joints and reduce pain naturally include nutraceuticals like Boswellia, turmeric, and even CBD. However, it's always important to talk to your veterinarian first before starting something new, especially if they're on any medications. Make sure to follow these simple tips and get your pet ready for those longer hikes or the crazy play at the dog park to help avoid these common strains and sprains. And many of these supplements can be used preventatively, but don't be afraid to try them if your dog ends up with an injury. If you found this short video helpful, click that like button below. Make sure to check out our other videos on more natural remedies to help your dogs thrive. I love hearing from amazing pet parents like you. So if you have other pet health topics you'd like to hear about, make sure to leave a comment down below. As always, you have the power to help your pet live a long and vibrant life. Together, we can make the change that's needed to help your fur family thrive naturally. Until next time, I'm Dr. Katie, the Natural Pet Doctor. Take care, pet parents.